Link engaged.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the StarCraft II Team Speak Team Liquid Open. I am DJ Wheat. Joining me is Chill, and we have got our second game between TLO and Drewby about ready to get started here. Let's go right to the countdown, and then you introduce the players. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, so we're in game two of semifinal A on Shakur's Plateau. Spawning in the top left as the blue Terran, up 1-0, is Root Drewby, fantastic Terran player out of British Columbia, Canada. And spawning in the top right, part of the actual Team Liquid, is the red Zerg player, Liquid TLO.
And interesting positions here. You know, I want to just point something out. I've been playing a buddy. He wants to, like, really get better at Shakuris, and so we've been playing almost exclusively this map. And every single time I play with him, we get these spawning positions. Like, I mean, he's been playing Zerg, and I've been playing off races, and he always gets these spawning positions. And I think that these actually really kind of suck for Zerg. I mean, obviously, you want to have down here the longest path between the two, but also there's this fear of the back door all the time. Like, neither player can really take it down without the fear of some sort of aggression. But if one player feels like they have an advantage, it can be really nasty. So I'm curious to see what TLO is going to do, if he's going to go for an early pool here. Does have a drone out, and there he will blow his pool down at 12. Meanwhile, we have the barracks going up for Drewby.
Yeah, I think what Drewby's going to do in these positions is similar to what he did in game one. Get a wall off his front door, probably take a very quick expansion at his natural. And then I think, as you said, his attack path will be through the back door, through the destructible rocks. Very easy to attack through there, as opposed to dealing with all the creep spread in the middle. And you don't see too many Zerg players who kind of anticipate that by throwing creep down there, or even keeping overlords back there to watch. A lot of top Zerg players have been caught with their pants down when, you know, a 60 food Terran army suddenly rolls into their main base.
Right, it's not fun. Stim, you know, you see him stim up, and next thing everything's going down. Even if you got a few spine crawlers back there, you got to be ready for it. So we do have barracks number two going down here, possibly something to complete the wall. First Marine coming out as well. Overlord is going to spot the positions right here, and this Overlord going down anyway. SCV scouting here for Drewby, sees that there is no expansion, but will be met up by a couple of Zerglings right away. Two pairs going to pop out, and the Queen should be right behind. Going to see no gas down, so he knows that there's no speedlings. Might be another opportunity for Drewby to at least be somewhat aggressive with his Marines. Last time he pushed with four, did some damage. However, that's still a pretty long walk, Chili. You got to go through the middle and then up to the expansion. He is going to throw down his expansion about 21 as well.
Yeah, I'm really not digging TLO's build here. It seems just way, way too safe. He gets his expansion way too late. Yeah, he's got a lot of drones coming out. He's keeping pace with the income tab, but really puts no pressure on Drewby whatsoever. Drewby feels no need to attack because there's no expansion. Drewby has no fear because there's no extractor. It's just all a little too safe for me. I'd like to see TLO play a little differently moving forward. And we'll see the result here as Drewby has his SCV sitting here. Gonna take his natural very, very comfortably here, and then probably throw down the geysers and start the barracks pump.
And he does, TLO does have a Roach Warren going down right now. Last time he had pretty much been forced into a Roach Warren after that early push. And we do have a move out here by Drewby with about eight Marines. And we are gonna see Zergling spot this, not only at the tower, but they are gonna make their way back. And that Roach Warren, he's got SCVs behind, so this is going to be a pretty big push here for Drewby. But as we've seen, a lot of times Terran can recover just fine. They use those SCVs and they have no problem. Roaches, there's only two of them about ready to pop out. This is not looking good for TLO.
Oh, and he's actually gonna get his queen surrounded here by the SCVs. The first one getting completely ambushed. Looks like Ruby's gonna do a little bit of micro and take out the second queen. That is so, so huge. It doesn't even matter what happens with this attack now. The damage has already been done, and Ruby's showing off his micro a little bit, doing some significant damage on the Zerglings, taking them all out. We've got some roaches out, but they're being completely ambushed by the SCV Marine count here by Ruby, and he's still off the creep, so he can still dance against these slow Zerglings. Really, he could be picking off these Zerglings as he runs away. And oh my god, just so much value out of these units. His expansion gets up comfortably. He's falling a little bit behind in his macro, but it doesn't even matter. Just such nice aggressive play here by Ruby.
Yeah, very, very nice. And more Marines. Hey, where are you going? They get caught from behind. He's going to try to bring his Zerglings forward. These two roaches really trying to maximize their damage. Here comes two more as well. And he could win this game, or he could win this battle with these numbers. Two healthy roaches will chase those Marines away. But actually, a ton of damage done there. About 200 behind in economy right now. Only one harvester behind as well, as these roaches are going to give a little bit of chase. Which actually may not be a terrible idea. Those Marines are pretty hurt, and there's not a whole lot back. We've got four roaches out here right now. One of them pretty significantly hurt, but I don't see any more coming to assist here. So he'll go ahead and get speed. He is going to push up, and he sees that he has put those into a bunker and will immediately retreat. But I did like the fact that TLO did kind of push forward there and at least say, okay, well, I can apply some pressure too. You can see here Drewby starting to get his expansion up, and those roaches will go back. But what will be TLO's next push? Look at this. He's actually got a roach going for the back rock. So maybe he's going to try to get the upper hand there in the back door.
Yeah, you know, roaches really clean up Marines. It's just the bunker that kept Ruby alive. So if TLO can push out a bunch of roaches, take down the back door of Ruby and get in there and be able to fight, you know, a one-on-one fight with Speedling Roach against Marines, he'll be able to do significant damage. TLO was really, really badly hurt by that rush. Losing all the units, not that big a deal, but losing the queens was the big issue. And
yeah,
you can see he's a little bit frazzled. He actually doesn't even have his second hatchery rallied to the minerals, so his drones are just spawning sitting outside the hatchery. So hasn't really adjusted. And look at the scan. You're going to see those rocks go down. Going to see all the units sitting there, and Drewby should be able, look at this, already putting a depot up by his rocks. So he's well aware of what is coming.
Very well aware. Also, you should note that the drone production for TLO has gone down considerably. He is rallying a lot more units here, as this last little bit is going to try to make a pretty epic push here. He does stop that supply depot, moves it back just a little bit. Where is the force of Drewby? Here come a couple of Hellions and one single Marauder. But these rocks are going to go down pretty quickly. Here comes a bunker as well. More roaches coming into play, and we will see the Zerglings go back to minimize their damage there, and this should be an interesting attack.
Yeah, Drewby really screwed that up, but getting some big shots with the Hellions. Roach is running right up, going to be able to take out the Marines, but with the SCVs coming out in front, trying to block off, and the bunker is not complete. Bunker actually taking a lot of damage despite not being complete. Marauder's flanking, but where are these queens going? Oh my god.
Oh no.
What are you doing? Looks like Drewby is going to be able to hold off. He's going to finish the bunker and be able to stabilize. Little bit of a transfusion, but that's more cuteness points than anything, as this is man style, where you just drive basic units down and A move through your opponent, and that's how Drewby's doing it right now. TLO getting fancy here, but he may want to stop that.
Wow.
Queen's still alive. I'm actually really surprised the attack continues.
Wow, we got a tank out as well. Another bunker being constructed in the back. There we've got one bunker down. We have Marauder go inside it. Two more Marauders in that bunker, and it is beautiful timing for Drewby, getting those buildings complete and walling off, well, not really walling off, but at least putting a wall of defense right here. There just simply were not enough roaches to break through there. And now it becomes a really uncomfortable situation for TLO here, because this back door is open. And now it's like, okay, well, I'm going to wait for Siege. I'm not sure. It's not quite done. And then I'm just going to push forward, and I'm going to make you choke through this back here. So you can see that TLO knows this. He's got a spine crawler down as well. And taking a look at the income, a huge, huge advantage for our Terran player, Drewby, right now, as he's got his second base up and running. No second gas on there. A lot more gas coming out here for TLO. His lair just finished, so it'll be, you know, I don't know what he could do at this point. He does not have a huge unit count. 8 roaches, 4 zerglings, and he is higher on the drone count, but he does not have much of an army right now.
So there was just a little bit of Hellion harassment. 3 blue flame Hellions drove into the natural. TLO spotted it a ways away as he controls the watchtower and just flanked that out with the roaches. So TLO trying to stabilize now as we bring up the production tab. A lot of drones have been made, but he's now getting the Glaal reconstitution, so roach speed, also putting down the spire, trying to transition into a normal game. But as you said, there's going to come a point where TLO is really going to wish he had those rocks open, and that point is coming really quickly.
Yeah.
The one thing he's doing to try to deal with this is spread the creep down, because he knows the push is going to come in that northern direction, so he's spreading the creep in that direction. This is probably the first time I've ever seen a Zerg player react like this, and he's going to need it, as here comes the big push from Drew.
Oh, no. His army is way out of position. He's got a few roaches down here, and he's got basically nothing over here. I don't think these two little hero Zerglings are going to do much of anything. And, of course, this Spinecrawler is going to get targeted right away. He's going to get some nice hits there on that Hellion, and that will minimize some drone kills there. But he's got to get his units up here. Drone's moving back, and there's just absolutely nothing. The pool is going to go down, and now we've got these tank seeds. They're going to have to go past that army, but they can't quite make it as they are just melted coming out of that hatchery. And we have no Ulysses even being made here. Roaches are being pumped out. We've also got a few other upgrades, but it just may not matter. Here comes the big push by TLO. He's going to move forward with all of his drones, take out those siege tanks first, now go after this little bio group, and maybe he will stop this, but at what cost? 5 more roaches on the way. He might have an army to make a decent counter push here, and he is going to go for it. No, he's going to have to stop some reinforcements right there, but if he waits for these next sets of roaches, maybe he could do some additional damage here.
Yeah, I think TLO needs to calm down and stabilize. He actually didn't... he actually did lose his lair.
Yeah,
so that's a really big deal. I thought he built his lair at his natural, but apparently I'm mistaken. So without a pool and without a lair, yeah, maybe I take that all back, because he's really running out of options if he waits to get a pool down, to get a lair down. Like, look at the production tab. Two Mutilus versus, like, bing, 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 bing,
yeah,
bing, bing.
Exactly.
It's getting out of control, so.
Everything a Terran can make is going down right now, pretty much. Stim also just finishing, which will be huge. Now, here's something I kind of like. The entire army of Drewby is pretty much up here. There are a few units up here, as you can see, a tank and a nice little bio force. And now he is going to make a counterattack at the front with his roaches, which I do kind of like. It would take these units a while to get back here. Actually, he doesn't have much of everything. He has moved to the front here. So Mutas are going to go in, and they could move that army out of position even more.
Yeah, and he's got 4 Mutas on the go, so that's a really nice choice. One of the only ways that I think TLO could get back into this game would be with just sick Muta harass. Drewby is prepared. He's got a turret in his main mineral line. Natural looks a little bit empty as the Mutas fly in. One getting picked off, the other one deep in the red. Reinforcements fly in. Oh, he grabs it very quickly. So Drewby is on top of it. Oh my god, more Mutas getting taken out here.
No.
TLO cannot be using these like these. He's got, and looking at his hotkeys, is this how he normally plays? He's got hatcheries on 1 and Mutas on 2 and 3. Very strange. Mutas flying in to now try to take out the tanks, the bunker, and other Marines shooting at them. And the wheels have really fallen off the TLO in game number 2 here.
Yeah, he got just a few units right there. Maybe he's going to make a push with those roaches here if he can move some of the army out of position. But as you can see, these Mutas just doing everything that they can. Drewby now finally moving some Marines up. He's got to watch out for that missile turret as it goes down as well. And no units currently coming out. Here we've got some Hellions moving into the main as well for Drewby, into TLO's main from Drewby. And he could go down to this natural right now and roast a ton of drones right now. The only thing that would be there is that queen. And here we go, big force moving out as the roaches are gonna get caught right there. And Drewby may just go ahead and run over this army. Oh my gosh, a beautiful time to push. The GGs are exchanged, and how quickly it is over.
I'm a little bit underwhelmed with TLO's performance, to be quite honest, but nothing taken away from Drewby. I thought he performed outstandingly in game one, and in game two he handled that little crisis at his rocks very well, which was the only time he was under pressure.
So good games to both players, but we will see Drewby moving forward, and I do wish him luck in the finals. TLO not going to be able to hold it down here for Team Liquid in this particular second game, but we've still got one Liquid member left in semifinal number two. That's going to be Rhett versus Keyhole coming up here in just a moment. And I don't know, I haven't gotten those replays yet, so let me check here. Actually, why don't we go ahead and it does look like they are in mailbox, so let's go ahead and take a quick break. When we come back, we will have Liquid Rhett taking on Keyhole, another Terran, 20.